Although I personally think there are aspects of Pulp Fiction that are much more interesting, the briefcase mystery has become a sort of million-dollar question among fans of Tarantino's work. It's Elvis's gold outfit, it's a nuclear bomb, the Holy Grail, an Oscar, gold bullion, or is it Marcellus's soul, which has been taken out of his neck, hence the plaster on his neck, and is now contained in the briefcase? Now don't worry, I'm not going to rehash that Marcellus's soul theory because frankly, I don't buy it. Firstly, it makes no sense. Why would the devil take out his soul and put it in a briefcase, and why would everyone else then want that briefcase? And if his soul is missing, then how is the physical Marcellus still carrying on in life? As has been pointed out by other debunkers, there is no biblical passage stating that a person's soul can be taken out of their neck by the devil. I've searched around myself online and found no mythological or religious stories of that nature. And why not stitches instead of a plaster? Or why not just show a big scar on Ving Rhames' neck, being that the actor actually has one? The same metaphor could be achieved with the scar itself. And why are there no other details in the film that further communicate such a theme? So let's scrap that stupid theory. When I first saw Pulp Fiction, I just assumed it was gold bullion in the case because of the orange-yellowish glow that appears whenever the case is opened, and because gold has been revered throughout history. But, as has been pointed out by those oh-my-god crazy online film theorists, gold is actually a very physically heavy metal, and a briefcase full of it would therefore be pretty heavy too. That doesn't mean it isn't gold bullion, because the weight issue could just be a factor ignored or overlooked while filming. But the one detail that has been pointed out by many fans and theorists that is certainly not accidental is the 666 combination to the briefcase, the number of the beast, the number of evil. And it's not the only spiritual realm reference. There's the bullets magically passing through Jules via divine intervention, and later on there's Jules' speech where he talks of evil in the world and evil men, which possibly links to the 666 combination.
Or it could mean, you're the righteous man, and I'm the shepherd, and it's the world that's evil and selfish.
Now there are all kinds of online forums and articles claiming that Tarantino has said this or that about the briefcase, but most of them don't provide direct verifiable sources, so as far as I'm concerned they're just rumours. So I've dug around and found just one video clip of Tarantino personally talking about the briefcase, and one audio interview with actor Phil LaMarr, who played the character Marvin. Marvin is the one who lets the gangsters in the room in the first briefcase scene. Here's what Tarantino had to say.
So, on MySpace, we're finally going to reveal, after all these years, Quentin has finally broken down, what is in the case, briefcase, in Pulp Fiction?
Yeah, since 1994, people have been asking me, what's in the briefcase? What's in the briefcase? And I keep saying, whatever you think, which isn't a BS argument, it's just, okay, after all this time now, I figure, on MySpace, the best audience ever, I can reveal it.
Just for you.
So, in the briefcase that Marsellus Wallace is trying to get, when you open it up, when you look in it, it's...
Complete sense.
Yes!
That makes complete sense. And it changes how you see the whole movie.
But you can see why I didn't want everyone to know that, because I like them all making their own movie, but...
I gotta go back and watch it now.
You gotta watch it now.
Now
it'll make, yeah.
It actually changes every movie you've ever made.
Yeah, it does, actually. Because it doesn't just apply to Pulp Fiction, it applies to all of them.
That's awesome. Just for you guys.
Incidentally, I didn't put the missing reel caption in, that's how the original interview was edited. Okay, so obviously Tarantino is having fun there. He's feeding into the debate by implying that there is a hidden truth about the briefcase, but he first said that what's in the briefcase is whatever you think it is. And that latter point tallies up with what actor Phil LaMarr had to say about his experience of filming the scene.
I asked Quentin, what's in the briefcase? And he said, it's whatever you want it.
So even that early, he knows what he's doing. But what literally was in the briefcase? A light?
A light.
Okay.
Small light.
So that's the answer.
Yellow light, reflective. Yeah.
A light is in the briefcase.
A low wattage yellow bulb.
I was thinking about, for this episode, I often do a second little segment at the end about the myth of the briefcase. But it seems pretty clear that it's A, whatever you want it to be.
Right.
But B, it's a light.
But the funny thing is, I just took that as the answer. I'm like, oh, okay. And then years later, I went, wait, that's not even a full answer. Is it whatever I want it to be?
What do you want it to be, Phil?
Or is it whatever whoever opens it wants it to be?
I think
Is it the viewer? Oh. Is it like the audience? It's like, it is whatever you want it to be. Or is the person who opens it seeing?
I think it's both.
You know, but see, there's a difference. If it's whatever, if John Travolta opens it up and sees whatever he wants to see, then it's a magical briefcase.
Okay, yeah, I see what you mean.
You know, if it is a concept, it is the most precious thing ever, then it is whatever the audience wants it to be.
I didn't know we'd go this deep. You know, I'm loving it.
But see, now here's my thing. I believe it is the latter, that it is whatever the audience wants it to be, because Vincent is a functionary. Vincent is opening it to check. Uh-huh. Vincent has to be told what to check for.
So he wouldn't have his own notion of what it is because he already thinks it's something else?
Or maybe Marcellus, like, so...
And yo, when you get the briefcase, check, make sure.
It's like, well, what is it?
It's whatever you want it to be.
Maybe that's it. Maybe that's what Marcellus told him.
So assuming Lamar's account of the shoot is honest and is not based on what he has since read on the internet, and assuming his memory of the experience is not distorted over the years, it's very plausible that the contents of the briefcase is just a MacGuffin, as they call it, a meaningless plot device designed to generate audience debate and personal projection of meaning. But at the same time, it could be that Tarantino did have an idea, either consciously or subconsciously, of what he intended the contents of the briefcase to be, and that both on set and after the film's release he has simply avoided giving an honest verbal explanation, possibly even because he hasn't been able to find the right words to explain it even to himself. If you've ever directed a film, then you'll know that sometimes you make decisions without having a conscious explanation. The MacGuffin explanation is also conflicted in several details. If Tarantino wants us to project our own meaning, then why skew our projection by putting the evil 666 number as the combination to the case, which is an implication of a conceptual code being cracked? Now, he might just be fucking with us, right? But then there's another detail that I've not heard talked about in any of the existing theories that I've read.
And you will know my name is the Lord when I lay my vengeance upon thee.
Those orange fades are easy to overlook because of the orange gun flashes. But nevertheless, it's a really unusual and 100% deliberate piece of editing. I've never seen this done with gunfire in any other movie. So, 666 combination, biblical execution speech, and an orange glow during the execution which parallels the orange glow in the briefcase, and then the divine intervention that saves Jules and Vincent. So we have multiple implications of something going on of a spiritual nature. Let's cross-reference some other details. Jules describes the contents of the briefcase as his boss's dirty laundry.
It's in a case.
My boss's dirty laundry.
Your boss makes you do his laundry?
When he wants it clean.
Sounds like a shit job.
Funny, I was thinking the same thing.
The phrase dirty laundry means embarrassing secrets that a person tries to keep out of the public eye. And that's a funny parallel with the fact that Marcellus later asks Butch to maintain a very embarrassing secret that he took it up the arse by the hillbillies.
Don't tell nobody about this.
The contents of the case has a mesmerizing effect on those who look into it. It induces admiration and the desire for ownership.
We happy? Vincent? We happy?
Yeah, we happy.
Open it.
Wait, what is it? What is it?
Is that what I think it is?
Mm-hmm.
It's beautiful.
God damn it, what is it?
We're not told exactly where the briefcase comes from, but we're led to believe that it was somehow stolen from Marsellus Wallace. And we don't know how Marsellus came across it either. Fortunately, actor Phil Lamar has explained the backstory that his character Marvin was tracked down by Jules because he'd bragged to some friends about the briefcase, and the word eventually made it back to Jules, who then tracked Marvin down and told him if he didn't lead the way to the briefcase, then he would be in big trouble. This makes perfect sense. It explains the hostility of Jules to Marvin.
Why don't you tell my man Vincent where you got the shit here at?
It's over there.
I don't remember asking you a goddamn thing.
And it explains why Marvin is taken by surprise and his friend's being killed. It also tallies up with the notion that some spiritual force associated with the briefcase causes the execution of Brett and his buddies, and then Marvin himself.
I mean, do you think that God came down from heaven and stopped...
Oh, what the fuck's happening? Oh.
As if that force was using Jules and Vincent as earthly tools to punish these lost children, as Jules puts it, for having taken the briefcase. So there seems to be a general implication that the contents of the briefcase is like some sort of forbidden fruit, as if those who open it are struck by temptation and are consequentially punished when they try to steal the case. Some fans and reviewers have noted that there's a supernatural golden glow similarity to the contents of the Ark in the first Indiana Jones movie. And again, in that instance, the Ark punishes trespassers who attempted to try and own the Ark and its contents.
Marion, don't look at it. Shut your eyes, Marion. Don't look at it, no matter what happens.
It's beautiful.
And Indiana Jones himself is arguably being aided and guided throughout the story by the Ark as its heroic protector. It's also notable that in Pulp Fiction, Vincent looks into the briefcase, refuses to acknowledge divine intervention, and later dies. But Jules manages to avoid looking inside, acknowledges God's intervention, and survives. Jules is also specific about saying that the case doesn't belong to him, while Ringo and Brett's crew wanted to own it.
But I can't give you this case, because it don't belong to me.
Regarding the orange-yellow glow and the possibility of gold bullion being inside the case, Pulp Fiction does have other allusions to gold as being something of both physical and conceptual value. For example, Marsellus Wallace has a gold wedding ring and gold earrings, and Jules has a gold watch and a gold chain around his neck. Those are most likely incidental details because we'd expect that of rich men and gangsters anyway. And some other incidental details that might have relevance if we were desperately trying to connect them are the film's title appearing in orange on top of red, Marsellus Wallace having an orange sweater here and an orange shirt here, though he isn't wearing orange in his two other scenes, and Jimmy's house is orange on the outside, which seems to have no particular relevance. So these instances of the colour orange can be taken with a pinch of salt, but much more relevant is the gold watch story, in which Butch has to experience his own version of the wars and traumas experienced by his forefathers, and the watch itself holds almost spiritual reverence for him. He wears a yellow robe before boxing, and there are lots of little clues throughout his story alluding to his forefathers and the gold watch itself. It's a separate story to the one about the briefcase, I know, but it does associate value to gold that is beyond financial measure, and Marsellus Wallace is in both stories. And eventually there's the detail that we don't actually see Jules give the briefcase to Marsellus. He takes it to the toilet with him while Vince goes over to Marsellus without the case. This is Jules' last scene chronologically, so we're left to merely assume that the briefcase was actually given. So, taking into account all these gold, supernatural briefcase details and the statements of Tarantino and actor Phil LaMarr, I believe that the real meaning of the briefcase content is that it represents